GIMP is very powerful free image editing software. You can do a lot with it, including making GIF animations. Let's have a look at how to make GIF animations in GIMP. Hello everyone, it's Rich Linux User, helping you to install, configure and use Linux. I make video tutorials every Wednesday and Friday. Subscribe and click the bell notification, so you won't miss any new video. In the previous video, you have learned how to make a GIF animation from images with the Linux command line. If you have not watched that video, I'll leave the link in the description. Using the command line is a very fast way to make a GIF, but the command line is not for everyone. So in this video, you will see how to make a GIF in GIMP, a free image editing software. The process is independent of the operating system you use, because GIMP is the same on Linux, Windows and Mac. Open GIMP, go to File, Open as Layers, and select all the images you want to make a GIF of. When all the images are imported, go to this layer panel and make sure that the order of the images is as you want it to be. The animation will be in the bottom-up direction. This is the first frame and this is the last one. You can use file names to order the layers. Alternatively, you can check all the layers by gradually making the top layer invisible. When you are sure that the order is as intended, you can crop these images. I don't have to crop much in these images. For the demonstration purpose, let's change the aspect ratio to 16 by 10. Fix this aspect ratio and fit the frame. When you are happy with what to crop, press Enter. Now let's resize these images, because they are quite large, and the GIF file will be large too. Go to Image, Scale Image, and here you can select the size and the resolution. You can keep the resolution at 72, but the GIF file will probably be too large. You need to find the lowest resolution possible, but not too low, when it is impossible to see what is in your GIF. I will use the value 50. The same applies to the size. You need to use as small size as possible. I will use 400 pixels on the longest side. Also, when you change the size, make sure that the proportions are locked. You can see it from this sign. Press Scale. Then make your zoom level 100%. This is how it will look in the real size in your GIF. Assess its quality. If it is too small and low resolution, undo the changes by pressing Ctrl+Z or through this menu. And adjust the size and resolution until you are satisfied with the results. Next, go to Filters, Animation, and optimize these images for GIF. This will open all your layers in the new tab, and you can see that some information is removed from the images. This will further reduce the size of the images and thus the GIF size. Also, you need to save this project, because it is open as a separate instance. Go to File and click Save. After that, go to Filters, Animation and select Playback. Now you can see how your animation will look like frame by frame. If everything is fine, go to File and export this project as GIF. Make sure it is exported as animation. Enable loop, and here you need to specify the delay between frames. I will use 100. I don't really know what the rest of the options do, so I select I don't care. And export it. Then go and check your GIF. If you are not happy with the speed, in my case the animation speed is too fast, you can go back and adjust the delay. I will increase it to 200. Export again. Now the speed is reasonable. Also, go to the properties of your GIF and check its size. If it is too large, you need to go back and reduce the size and resolution of your images. GIFs tend to be very large, but my simple GIF is pretty small, as you can see. What way do you like more? Making GIFs with the command line, as I showed previously, or the way you learn in this video with the graphical interface. You can vote here in the top right corner or comment below. If you need to make a GIF from a video file, please wait for the next tutorials. I will show you how to extract frames from a video with FFmpeg and VLC Media Player. So again, you will have a choice between the command line and the graphical interface. If you watch this video a week after it was uploaded, then those tutorials are probably already available. Just search for them on the channel. Thank you for watching!